obtaining the Taylor series for a function by multiplying the series together, two series together, substitution, and doing it directly. Consider f of x equals sine 2x. We can get the Taylor series at x equals 0 a few ways. Three ways are shown here. Number one, not in any order of easiness. Number one, multiplying the series. Okay, so sine 2x is 2 sine x cosine x. So that's 2 times the sine x times the cosine x. So now we just need like 3 terms just to see if we can get a pattern. The terms shown here are enough to produce all the x terms, x to the third, and x to the fifth terms for the entire product. And that is because the next one here is x to the seventh. When that multiplies by the lowest, you're going to get x to the seventh. So that's not going to be an x to the fifth term. And over here, x to the sixth is the next one. X to the sixth times x is going to be x to the seventh. So all the x cubed, and x to the fifth terms in the entire product will be produced by products of these terms shown. So we just multiply them. X times 1 is x. That's the only way to get to the x to the first term. The x to the third term, you can get by this times 1, or x times x squared. That produces these two. The fifth terms, you can get by this times this times this, or this times this. Okay, so I've written those down. Now, I want to have some kind of a pattern. This is where this got a little tricky. I could try multiplying all the numbers out and get common denominators. And that probably would work. You'd probably see the pattern after a while, but I don't like to lose sight of these factorials. So what I decided to do was get the common denominator here. I need a 3. I needed a 3 here to make this 3 factorial, so I have to multiply in the numerator. That's how that was gotten there. So now that's 3 factorial. So that pretty much matched those up. Then here I decided to go, since that was a 3 and that was a 3, I decided to go for 5 factorial. This one already had it. This one, I had a 3 factorial already. So I needed it multiplied by 20, 5 times 4. So I did 5 times 4, then I had to multiply by 5 times 4 here. And then I just moved the 2 factorial up there to divide by it. So I got this. 5 times 4 is 20, dividing by 2 factorial. And then 5 times 4 times 3 factorial is 5 factorial. And then this one, all they had to do is multiply by a 5 and a 5 up there. And I get 5x to the fifth over 5 factorial. So now I'm at it, ready to add everything up. I get x. I have negative 3 minus 1 is negative 4. And then I have here 20 divided by 2 factorial, that's 2. That's 10, 11, 16. 16x to the fifth over 5 factorial. And it was 2 times that. So I multiply that in and to every term and got this. And then I see the pattern. I have k equals 0 to infinity. A negative 1 toggle switch with the first one being positive at k equals 0. Then I have these odd powers. 2k plus 1. And I have 2 to the odd powers. 2 to the third is 8. 2 to the fifth is 32. That matches up with these. So I get, if I can get it over here again, I get this here, and I have 2 to the 2k plus 1 and over my factorials. So that's it. Second way of doing the same problem. Substitute 2x into the series for, that's actually sine of x. Okay, sub 2x in there. So sine of x is this. And then, so I just, not to get confused, I put the u in there instead. Then I let u equal 2x, put that in there. Kind of easy the way that happens. 2 to the 5th is 2 to the 5th. 2 to the 3rd, 2 to the 3rd. I have this, and I easily change that into the summation form, and that's the same as the above. Same thing. Then using the Taylor series directly, that's just, you don't use any of that fancy stuff. You just say sine of 2x. You get your derivatives. Here's all your derivatives. Evaluate it at 0. You get all these numbers. Put them in the numerators with your factorials in the denominators. And you get this pattern, which turns into the summation, which is exactly the same as the other two.